covers pet cloning. It's often fluff pieces and these warm, fuzzy pieces about, oh, look how cute these animals are, and isn't it cool that we could do this? And there's very little coverage, if any, of what it really meant to clone that animal and what it took.
I think it more of reproduction. If we had created her, we'd have started from nothing and made her, but we started with ova from other cats and cells from another cat and just put them together in a way that they can reproduce. You know, that's not vastly different than people that arrange for mating, so it's just that we threw in some technology. Professor at Texas A&M University. Been working in the area of embryo transfer, cloning, and genetic engineering. My dream was to become a farmer, and I went to the university intending to just get what I needed to come back. And then I got bit by the research bug. My father was very disappointed that I didn't come back to the farm. My mother said, well, I knew you'd find something better. And I didn't mean that it was better, it was just different. And cloning, as it's most customarily practiced at the present, involves the transfer of nuclei from cells and transferring those cells into eggs where the nucleus has been removed, and then the nucleus from the animal to be cloned is put in its place. If it's a mammal, those new embryos then have to be transferred into recipient females for them to carry on to term. And usually those recipient animals nurse them and raise them as well. And this is the first of the deer to be cloned. This is Dewey. Yeah, that's the students that named him after me. I think it's because I insisted that he be allowed to be born natural birth, and he survived. And I think that earned me that privilege, I guess.
The truth is that cloning is highly experimental and very problematic, and most of the time it doesn't work. You know, only a few clones have actually been born successfully, and of the ones that have been, a good percentage actually end up dying within the first 6 months because they have some sort of complication, health abnormality, a physical deformity, something like that. You talk about using a very large number of animals to even try to produce just one clone.
Some people just don't like anything that's unnatural and think they can abide by that, but of course most of the things they do are unnatural. I think it has to do with the Hollywood version, to some extent, of cloning. You know, they've always pretty much made it a monster kind of activity. Well, I hope that there will be continued research to make it more dependable. At present, about 25% of offspring have some type of abnormality. They're developmental abnormalities. They're not mutations. They don't get passed on to the next generation, but they need special care. These are microscopes that we use to find the eggs. We have to get the eggs out of ovaries. It is simple after you learn how to do it, but there are just many, many details that have to be followed. And if you do one thing wrong, then the chain is broken and you get nothing from it. Well, our team is working on genetic engineering of livestock to produce animals that are resistant to disease. This is the cloned bull that's resistant to brucellosis, which is a disease that causes abortion in cattle and undulant fever in humans. The original bull was naturally resistant to it. His cells that were used for cloning him have been stored for 15 years. His name is Bruce, after brucellosis. the process of selective breeding to produce superior individuals has been going on for many years, even using natural breeding. And then embryo transfer and artificial insemination made that process more efficient, where you could get more offspring from the genetically valuable animals. If they're superior and can't reproduce by themselves, then the techniques such as cloning can produce offspring. Anything we do could be used incorrectly and wrongly, and most things are by somebody somewhere sometime.
Chinese scientists have derived stem cells from cloned embryos created by combining human DNA and rabbit eggs. Others have announced plans to produce cloned children, despite the fact that laboratory cloning of animals has led to spontaneous abortions and terrible, terrible abnormalities. Human cloning is deeply troubling to me and to most Americans.
The issue of human cell storage is one that we have not dealt with. We don't have any, don't even have my cells stored here. We have not worked at all with the human cells. Anyone who could effectively culture and preserve cells from animals would be able to do so with humans as well. I still get goosebumps when I see an embryo. It's just kind of thrilling to be able to see something as simple as a little embryo that you know can develop into something as complex as a complete individual. Cece was, I think, a special cat because she was the first of the pets to be cloned. It's not a new creation. We're just helping with reproduction. Cats had more to do with it than we did. It was their eggs that made it possible, and the recipient that made it possible. I'm pleased with the result and pleased to have been a part of it. She's up in that window.
She's up in that window. If that's her favorite place. Hi, Cece. Come on, say hello, Cece. Hi, Cece. How you doing? Hi, Cece. I worried when Cece was expecting. I thought, oh, what if she's born with two children without ears and one without a tail? I'm going to have to say, oh, this is not good, but she came through for us. She came through. Cece came through. Cece's a good kitty. Cece's a good kitty. She said, I know, I know. Yeah. She knew exactly what to do. I really worried about that because I thought I'm going to have to buy little bottles and feed each kitten. No, I didn't have to. She was a wonderful mother.
That's in the genes.
It's in the genes.
Different species have different instincts and behaviors. That's one thing about the clones, you know, they all act like their own species.
Species, yeah.
It's a privilege to have been in a situation where we could do this, and also to be able to enjoy her is an added privilege. If people want to use their resources to get a genetic copy of their original pet, I don't see anything wrong with that.
There's a life that gets lived, a beginning, middle, and an end, and it's hard to deal with the end. But that's part of life, and trying to prevent that from being a part of life with this idea that you could somehow have the same animal your whole life. These are still animals, and they still very much matter, and to treat them like objects, you know, it's not really something that I find acceptable.
They say you're accusatory, you know, you're playing God, creating something, you know, no more than anybody else is creating. Besides, I'm doing it to serve God, not to take his place. And I'm not playing. This is my vocation. Yeah. Work.
Yeah.
But really good work.
There goes Cece.